In the thick of tax time and scammers, they are on the prowl targeting vulnerable Australians and their hard-earned cash. The ATO has released this audio of the latest scam making the rounds. Take a listen.
Your account has been marked delinquent on account of tax avoidance, as our letters sent to your registered address have also returned unsigned and undelivered, resulting into a petition note to be filed against your name, including a warrant for your arrest.
And we are joined now by Fiona Cameron from the Australian Communications and Media Authority. Thank you for your time this morning, Fiona. Are many people falling for these scams?
Yeah, look, it's tax time, and unfortunately, scammers are about. And this scam is pretty disgraceful. Effectively, the chances of being scammed are accelerated on the basis that robocalls are used, as you just heard. And if they can get to millions, maybe a dozen or 100 will be sucked in, and your life savings can go, or alternatively, your identity can be stolen. And once your identity is stolen, then the scammer can go on and scam someone else in your name, which is an appalling cycle of abuse.
Well, I mean, this one works, of course, by them phoning you, so it does target a lot of the vulnerable, a lot of the elderly who are at home with landlines. What are some of the other scams that are making the rounds at the moment?
Yeah, well, with COVID and lockdown provisions, we're all sitting ducks, unfortunately. We're close to the phone, we're online. Scammers are really playing to our vulnerabilities and our sense of insecurities. And there are a number out there. Amazon scams, you're waiting on your parcels. You know, Amazon rings, phones or emails and says you haven't paid the last $5. Rent scams, which are unconscionable, which, you know, you're highly pressured at the moment. There's an apartment up for rent. They scam you on that regard. Puppies, the latest, which are appalling as well. I mean, there's no puppies to be bought at the moment in COVID times, and there are no bikes to be bought either. So they look at what you're looking for and what you need, and they'll scam you. And they'll ring you and they'll pretend to know you and they'll have information on you. And often in relation to the ATO type scams, they pressure you. They say we're going to arrest you. They say you're going to go to federal court if you don't pay. Interest will compound, and you've really got to take care and be cautious. And if you're not sure, just hang up, because these people are out to get your money or your identity. And it's not like we're sitting on our hands at the moment as well. There's been a lot of initiatives happen this year. The government's put in new rules to ensure that your phone number doesn't easily get stolen. I mean, your phone number, Ali, could have been stolen last year just with someone having your name, your date of birth and your address. And once your phone number's stolen, your bank account is vulnerable, and then your whole identity goes, and someone else steps in your shoes and bees you and suddenly sells puppies online. A vicious circle.
I mean, it's remarkable then how easy it is, isn't it, for them to get this information. And my thing now is you almost think that everything's a scam. You received an email and you question it all. But, look, there's a lot to digest there. Fiona, thanks for coming on and talking to us this morning. We really appreciate it.